Well, good morning, guys. It's Pastor Andy. Today's February the 20th, and we're going to be looking together in Psalm chapter 20. Psalm chapter 20 is a psalm that David wrote right before he goes into battle, and most of the psalm is a prayer. It starts off this prayer before battle with all of the people praying. And you see in each one of the first six verses, you see the word may used, which means they are talking to God. It says, in times of trouble, may the Lord answer your cry. May the name of the God of Jacob keep you safe from all harm. The people are praying for David. Verse 2, may he send you help from his sanctuary and strengthen you from Jerusalem. May he remember all your gifts and look favorably on your burnt offerings. May he grant your heart's desire and make your plans succeed. May we shout for joy when we hear of your victory and raise a victory banner in the name of our God. May the Lord answer all your prayers. These people were very confident of the victory even before the battle because they were confident in God. They knew that God was going to take care of them. They pray for their king, they pray for the victory, and they have faith that God is going to do what he said he was going to do and take care of the nation of Israel. And when we pray, we're supposed to pray in faith as well, believing that God is going to do what he said, believing that God will take care of his children, believing that he loves us enough to give us the things that we need and to take care of us in every situation that we'll ever be in. The chapter goes on. Well, we read there in verse 5, the word victory is used twice. And then if you jump down to the last verse, it says, give victory to our king, O Lord. Answer our cry for help. You know, David planned his strategy, and David was a phenomenal strategist, a mighty warrior. Remember that even as a boy, he killed a lion and a bear, and then as a young man goes out against Goliath, the champion of the Philistines, and God gave him the victory. So David, the great army military leader, the great strategist, plans for this victory, plans for this battle, but they know that only God is the one who gives the victory. We can make plans and we can put plans together, but we have to understand that God is the one who determines the outcome. No matter whether it's in our life, in our job, whatever it is, it's good for us to make a plan. It's good for us to have goals. It's good for us to be thinking in the future, but we have to do that with a loose hand. We have to do ministry. We have to do life with an open hand. What does that mean? That means, God, my hands are open with everything that I have and all of my plans, and it's up to you. If you want to use my plan, we can do that. If not, Lord, everything that I have is yours. I just want to be on page with you. I want to follow you. We serve with open hands. God can take, God can give, God can do what God wants because he is God and I am not. So I hope you'll get into the Psalms and read them with us every day and do your own devotions. Get into God's Word. Follow along with us. Read extra. But get into God's Word. Study it and spend some time with him every day because he is that good Father who loves to spend time with us. He cares about us. He loves you. The Bible says every good and perfect gift comes from above. We know that all the things that we have that are good come from him. So let's spend time with him today. Show some appreciation to him today. Tell him how much you love him. And until tomorrow, God bless you and have a great day.